My house burned to the ground, along with almost every penny I had. There was even some trouble with the cops, but Eddie took care of that. And since I didn't have any insurance, I had to live in this shithole of an apartment till I could get back on my feet. At least I managed to save Leo. He disappeared without a trace. I doubt Frank Vinci even knew where he went. And even though Henry failed to deliver on the contract, Eddie still brought him in when he heard Leo had skipped town. Me and Joe had a new partner.
Hey, Vito. It's Henry.
Hey.
Listen, I'm setting up something big. I want you to come in on it. If you're interested in hearing more, come meet me at Lincoln Park and bring a piece.
Okay. I'll see you there.
Hey, here he comes.
Hey!
What's up?
Hey, Vito. Take a seat.
All right, listen. I've been doing some research into Carlo's business.
So?
So, the only reason he had Clemente killed was because he was selling dope, too. And he was stealing his customers. Now he just needs to get rid of one last obstacle. The one guy who could fuck things up and ruin his plan to become the main supplier for the whole city. Frank Vinci.
Where'd you get all this?
I talked to a few people I trust.
Okay, so what does this have to do with us?
Of course, if he can do it, why can't we? A kilo of heroin costs 2,500 bucks over in France. Then it's another 1,000 bucks to get it here.
And?
And we pick up 11 grand for just driving the stuff to the dealers. That's 7,500 bucks profit a kilo.
Yeah, but what about Falcone?
Carlo won't find out. And even if he does, he'll just threaten us and demand a cut.
All right, but if Carlo's the only big supplier in the city, where are you going to buy the stuff from?
I'm way ahead of you. What do you two know about the Tongs?
The Chinks?
Some kind of organization for Chinese immigrants, right?
That's what I said, the Chinks.
Right, but it's also a front for their other operations. They run the Chinese quarter, and they keep to themselves. But some of them are interested in doing business with outsiders, and they need middlemen since most people are afraid to deal with them.
And we're the middlemen.
Yep. They'll give us 10 kilos to start.
For how much?
35 grand.
And we can sell it for...
110.
Nice.
Okay, well, where the hell are we gonna get our hands on 35 grand?
I know a loan shark, the Yid over on Palisade. I think a loan is 35, we give him 45 back. Now that means our take is over 20 grand a piece. Not bad for just moving the shit from one place to another.
But you know, who's gonna end up using this crap?
What do you care? As long as it isn't in our neighborhood.
Because Vinci was right. Drugs are bad news, they kill people.
Look, only idiots do drugs. Deadbeats and losers. If they want to kill themselves so badly, I'd gladly help them out. Especially for 20 grand. I got buyers in the ghetto. They'll take care of the distribution. So we don't need to worry about that. Are you guys in or not?
I'm in. Come on, don't be stupid, Vito. 20 fucking grand in one afternoon.
When?
Right now. If we don't take the offer, Towns will just find somebody else.
Come on, Vito, it'll be a piece of cake.
Let's go see Bruno then. Vito, how about you run us all down there? He's on Palisade Street.
Okay, let's go.
This guy we're gonna see, Harry.
His name's Bruno. He's one of the only guys in town who could do a loan this big.
But if he doesn't give it to us, then what?
Then the deal's off. But don't worry, I know this guy. He'll give us the money.
There ain't nobody else we can get this kind of money from?
There's three of the guys I know of. But if you want to ask Carlo or Frank Vinci for 35 grand, be my guest.
Yeah, no thanks.
Who's the third guy?
He ain't in business no more. Somebody blew up a room full of his guys and shot him point blank in the face with a Tommy gun.
Oh, that guy.
Come on, we said we wasn't gonna talk about that.
All right, so, Henry, what is this guy, rich or something?
I think he gets his money from some of the bosses from out of town who sit on the commission.
Yeah? No shit.
Yeah, which is why we can't stiff the guy. Besides, we gotta keep this quiet.
Don't we trust him?
Sure. Wise guy's been borrowing money from this guy forever. As long as we pay him back on time, we won't have a problem. This is it. Stop here.
Hi, fellas. We're here to see Bruno.
Hiya, Henry. If you got guns on yous, put them down there. I gotta search yous.
Hiya, Bruno.
Hello, Henry. So, to what do I owe the pleasure of your company today?
I need 35 grand in $20 bills.
Oh, that's a lot of money, Henry. A lot of money, tell me. Why should I give that much to a small-time guy like you, huh? Convince me.
I got a sure thing. You'll have 45 by the end of the week.
What kind of sure thing?
Sorry, Bruno. That's a trade secret.
Then 45 is not enough. I'd be more comfortable with 65.
That's a bit steep, even for you. 50's all I can do.
Henry, Henry, I have no guarantee I'll get my money back. And you have nowhere else to go. So, how about 60? Don't think of it as interest. It's more like my cut of the profits.
55, final offer. Anything more than that, it's not worth my time.
Deal. I'll give you $35,000 today, and you'll give me $55,000 by Friday. If you don't pay it back by then, the debt goes up by 10,000 every week.
You'll get it by Friday.
Okay. Isaac, prepare $35,000 in $20 bills. Now, you know I trust you, Henry, but if you screw me, remember these wise words from the Bible. And my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Exodus, chapter 22, verse 24.
I'm impressed. You don't seem like the church-going type. But just remember, the money isn't mine. So even if you get rid of me, that doesn't get rid of your debt. So no funny business, okay, boys?
Sure, Bruno.
Thank you, Isaac. You want to count it, Henry?
I'll take your word for it, and I'll bring it back on Friday along with your cut.
I hope so. Good luck, boys.
Hey,
Nice job.
Of course. I told you give us the dough, didn't I?
How come you know the Bible so good, Henry? You read it or something?
Uno always uses the same quote. I go to church on Sunday, so I ask the police one time.
You go to church?
Yeah, and I can understand why you don't. They use big words, there's no hookers, and the food's lousy.
Yeah, that pretty much sums it up.
Geez, I ain't been there since 45.
What? That time your mother made you go to confession?
Yeah, that time she snapped me for checking out some chick's cool. Nah, God rest her soul.
How about you, Joe? How long's it been?
Easter.
Ah, that ain't too bad.
1941.
I take that back then. You're going straight to hell.
What, you just figuring that out now?
Don't worry, I'll save seats for the both of you. You know, I heard about a long shot named Bruno once. Must be the same guy.
Yeah? Who'd you hear?
Well, you know Mickey the Crab, right?
What, the guy who cleans the bathrooms at Carlos' joint?
Yeah, the guy who's only got a finger and a thumb on his left hand. Guess how that happened? I heard he owed a lot of money to some yid from Southport. Get my drift?
Oh, right. I get the picture.
Haha, don't worry, though. Crab's a moron. Not like that's gonna happen to us.
We're almost there. Drive through the gate and into the yard.
Again, but this time, kids, it's official, as 48, count them, 48 countries have now signed a peace treaty with Japan that officially ends the war in the Pacific. Now, it took almost 6 years to get it done, but the agreement is binding.
All right, follow me, fellas, and let me do all the talking. Hey, we got some business with your boss.
Follow me, gentlemen. Mr. Wong is expecting you.
Welcome, Henry.
Hello, Mr. Wong.
Let us get straight to business. Is your suitcase heavy enough?
See for yourself.
Yo, Doc, this is 20,000美金钞票，一共35,000块.
All right, take it away and bring the goods. You're a good man, Henry. Here is your merchandise. Each bag contains 1 kilo. Each kilo weighs a little more than 2 pounds. Which one do you want to test?
Okay, we're good.
I'm glad. Next time, we can give you twice the amount.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Wong.
The pleasure was all mine.
Knock it off. See how easy that was? Get back in the car.
All right, fellas, the hard part's over. Now we just gotta make the exchange and we're done.
Sounds good to me.
Where are we headed?
Hunters. I got it all lined up.
Hello, gentlemen.
Fucking setup.
I think you have something for us. Drop the suitcases.
My shoes. Wait a minute. These guys ain't cops?
Kill the bastard! Shoot Vito! watch our back. Here comes more of them.
Hold on. I got him.
Bing. Nice. But there's still too many of them. Come on.
Shit, can't go back that way. Run.
Move your asses. Vito, watch our back. Stay away from these windows, fellas.
Damn it, Vito!
No sense
stay
staying
down.
Up here. Let's get down. Vito, kick the door in.
Let's go already. Kick it in.
These guys just don't fucking learn.
You better kill this fucking guy before we run out of bullets.
Shit, that was fucking close.
It's not over yet. They're coming after us. Fuck! Lose them!
Somebody else must have known about the deal. Those definitely weren't real cops.
Maybe it was the chinks trying to fuck us.
I doubt it. Look, I'll figure it out. But first, we gotta unload this stuff. Vito, take us to the old warehouse in Hunters.
All right. Hope this deal goes better than the last one.
It will. Not like it no any worse, right?
So who are we selling the stuff to?
A bunch of different guys.
Oh, whoa, whoa. What do you mean a bunch of different guys?
A bunch of different guys. What did all that shooting back there make you deaf?
I thought you said we were just moving this garbage from one place to another.
Yeah, well, you make a lot more money if you sell it in smaller amounts.
Would have been really nice to know before I agreed to go in on this.
If I did, from the way you're talking back in the park, you probably wouldn't.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the best you can hope for right now is to spend the next 30 years of your life breaking your ass for Eddie and Carla before you either get bumped off or end up back in the case. The only time you're ever going to see cash like this is if you stick in that time. Besides, I ever steer you wrong.
Well, there was the OPA job, and that time we almost got killed when we wiped that fat fucking Sand Island.
All right, enough. None of that matters after today. Let's just get the hunters. And don't worry, we're never going to have to see these scumbags again after today.
Unless this turns into a regular thing for us.
Well, all right, let's just concentrate on getting through this one before we go making plans like that, all right?
Hey, I'm just saying.
Vito's right. Let's just get through the rest of the day. After that, smooth sailing, fellas.
She drank a good thermometer. She drank a glass of wine. She's built just like a garter snake. She climbs up like a vine. My friends tell me I'm a fool to love a gal like that. Here's the reason I like them slim instead of...
Here we are. Let me do the talking. These are tough guys, so no wise-ass comments. All right, Joe?
Hey, guys, how you doing?
Hey, man. Come on in.
Shit! It's smoke! Oh, fuck. Did it! We hit the jackpot!
Hey, 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 take it easy. We're not done yet.
Lighten up, will you, Henry? What's the matter? All of a sudden, money don't make you happy?
After we pay back Bruno and you get your cut, then you could be happy.
All right, all right.
Hold it inside, baby, diamond ring. If that diamond ring don't shine, he gonna take it to a private eye. If that private eye can't see, he better not take the ring from me. Oh, dear, they call her Nanny Go, to make a pretty baby a Sunday Go. Oh, dear, they call her Bellcat, to make a pretty baby a Sunday Hat.
You ain't even gonna give me a tip?
You want a tip? I'll give you a tip. Don't let the door hit you in the ass on the way out.
Always the gentleman, huh, Joey?
Just get the fuck out of here
already.
Hey, Gina,
wanna come join me?
Hey, I hope there's room for three in there. Barbaro's Bordello. You got the money, we got the honeys.
Vito, it's Henry. We got a problem.
What kind of problem?
Eddie paid me a visit. Carlo knows about the deal, and he sent Eddie to pick up his cut.
How much?
$60,000.
Fuck, that much? What are we gonna do?
I don't know. We don't even have enough left for Bruno. Meet me in the park. I don't want to talk about this over the phone.
Okay. I'll be right there. Joe, we gotta go.
What?
What for?
Now, Joe. I'll tell you on the way.
CLA, Empire Classic Radio News. I'm Gary Stevens. What looked to be a tragic tale of the murder of several police officers turns out not to be the case. Initial reports from the scene at the CBF Fish Packing Warehouse in Oyster Bay stated that several police officers have been killed. In fact, the lives that were taken were those of several hardened criminals who were only dressed like police officers. We here at ECLA are immediately relieved that none of our city's finest lost their lives. Citizens can walk a little bit safer as for once, some ne'er-do-wells receive their comeuppance. This is ECLA News. I'm Gary Stevens.
Henry's different these days. Guy's got a real...
What the fuck's going on? Shit, that's Henry. What the fuck are they hitting him with?
Get on me!
Way to go, Vito!
Fuck! Who the fuck does something like this, Vito? Them people are fucking sick. Shit! Who the fuck does something like this?
Who do you think?
God damn it, Henry!
Look at this, Vito. You fucking believe this?
The money's gone too. Come on. We gotta get out of here. Cops will take care of Henry. Hey, that's the old guy who sold us the dope, Wong. Of all the ways to kill a guy, goddamn bullet would have been enough.
These bastards are sick in the head, Vito. They're gonna fucking die. All of them.
I mean, might do it like that. And in the middle of the park.
Like I said, they're sick. I'm gonna turn them into chop fucking suey.
Hey, not for nothing. We don't even know how many of them there are.
Yeah, and it don't matter.
Henry's dead. What, do you want us to get killed too? We gotta do this smart, Joe.
It don't matter how we do it. As long as they're fucking dead when we're done.
All right, listen. There's probably more than two of them.
So what? The more the fucking merrier.
So there's only two of us. Unless maybe you want to call Carlo and tell him all about the mess we're in and ask him to send some guys over here.
All right, fine. I get it.
All right, so promise me you're not going to go in guns blazing as usual. We got to do this the smart way. All right?
Now we know where to find them.
Let's get in there and take him out before he disappears with the money.
Hold on, I'm gonna need some serious firepower first.
We can either go to Harry's or we can kill these fucks right now. Just say the word.
Sorry, gentlemen, this place for member only.
Here's your fucking membership.
God damn it, Joe. Can't you listen to me for once?
No, I can't. You seen what they done to Henry.
God damn it, Joe. See? Why didn't you just bang the damn gong when you were at it?
Pipe down and help me waste these little fuckers.
Come on,
get the asshole behind the bar.
Hey, Joe, they home, huh?
Bingo.
From up top!
We don't know, lady!
We don't know!
Die, you piece of shit!
Come on, Vito! Let's move up! Get the guy on the stairs!
Four more to go, Vito!
Vito, move for Christ's sake!
Sheet.
Where the fuck are they all coming from?
Come up to China around here somewhere.
I gotta cut you to pieces!
All right, you go first, Vito. You're a smaller target.
Thanks, fat ass.
Hey, you said we gotta do this smart, right?
Boy, Batong!
Where the hell is that?
Yuck, no!
There's gotta be around here somewhere. Let's keep going. Jesus fuck, let's keep on coming. How many more they got back there?
Don't matter. I got plenty of bullets.
Let you go.
Special delivery for you.
Hey! Leave some of these little bastards for me.
Say goodnight, Joe.
Quiet, Vito.
Since when are you concerned about making noise?
There's too many of them. Just take them out nice and quiet. Nice. All right, let's just sneak through here.
deaf for what? You said we should fight. Is that the fucking best you got? Oh, you're in trouble. I'm going in. Did they teach you that in the army? More of them in the elevator!
Where's that fucking cop?
You shoot like my sister.
All right, that was the last of them. See? Ain't so bad so far, right?
Yeah, but what if somebody recognizes us and Carlo hears about it?
That's why we ain't leaving no witnesses. There's probably more of them down here. Get ready.
You're dead, you slanty-eyed fuck!
What is it that you want?
What the fuck do you think we want?
We want to know why you had our friend killed. We also want the money you took from him.
I had no choice. Your friend was a government informer.
What the fuck are you talking about?
A contact inside the Federal Bureau of Narcotics told me that Henry Tomasino passed them information about our deal.
That's a fucking lie!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You saying Henry was a rat?
Yes. But not anymore.
That's bullshit. Makes no sense. And I suppose you had nothing to do with the little stick-up after we closed the deal with you either, right?
You think we would take such a stupid risk and destroy our own factory? That was just another reason to get rid of you. We had problems with you from the very beginning.
Yeah? Well, all your problems are just about over, pal. So where's our money?
It's not here anymore.
What?
Where the hell is it, then?
I cannot tell you.
If you don't tell us, I'm gonna splatter your yellow brains all over this fucking room.
If I told you, I'd be dead anyway.
Fine. Your choice.
Are you crazy?
What you want to do? Let him go or something?
We could have gotten more out of him.
Fuck that. He wouldn't have said nothing. These bastards are tough.
Let's just get the hell out of here before the cops come. Like this place won't be opening up for a while.
If we had the time, I'd burn it to the damn ground.
Vito, come here. Ah, fuck this! Come on, Vito, let's get
this
out of here.
This guy's a maniac!
There's
too many! We gotta take him down!
Find us a car, quick!
Copy that. Officer down! Officer down! Shoot this asshole!
You're in trouble.
10-4.
They teach you that in the army? Come on, show yourself! You're fucking dead!
Alright, we lost him.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, dark hair, medium build.
Take me to my place, Vito.
Copy that.
I need a fucking drink.
That was fucked up, huh?
Yeah. I don't want to talk about it. Just get me back to my place, would you?
All right.
No.
This deal was a total fucking disaster.
Tell me about it.
Henry's dead. We don't have Bruno's money. We killed half the Tongs. And if they think Carlo sent us, that'll mean war. We're fucked.
Yeah. And if Carlo finds out we got him into this mess...
What if Henry really was a rat?
No fucking way. Don't even say that. Look, first let's get the money for Bruno. That'll fix at least one problem. But I'm done for today. I need a drink. Call you in the morning. We'll figure this shit out.
All right.
Okay, I'll see you later. And Vito, be careful.